the bidding on them at the sale, and you'll find the biggest buyers here during the course of those 2 days. We have 43 colts and fillies, and it's, I think, by far the largest draft, and it's one of the biggest drafts we've brought down here as Arrowfield. But this year, Arrowfield will market 160 yearlings, Wayne, so it's a fairly big endeavour.
They're bringing the good stallions out here, and we've just got to try and breed better horses and compete with them. And after all, once the yearlings are sold and they begin to race, once they go on the barriers and the gate crashes, they're all in a level playing field. It doesn't matter whether you come from Raheen or Coolmore.
And how many horses do you have in this sale?
We've got two horses, two colts in this sale, Wayne.
We've got $40 million invested in breeding in buttstock and properties in the Hunter Valley, so it's quite a large commercial operation. I think it's probably the largest Australian-owned commercial operation.
What pressure do you feel with the likes of Arrowfield and Coolmore having Dane Hills, horses like that to compete against?
They're on a different, those horses stand for 100,000 and we're standing horses for four. Our client base is very different to those folks.
John, amongst your draft, you've got some lovely stock here by great horses. What do you have?
Well, we have got some interesting horses here this year. We've got a number of colts and fillies by new season size. Dan Zero, De Hare, Flying Spur, Brocco, Catrail. They've all got two-year-olds now. That's a very exciting time, and we have the next crop on offer.
He's a nice type of
horse. Yes, he is a nice horse, isn't he?
Yeah. Well-grown animal.
Yes, he's well-grown. He's a first foal. His mother's a lovely big mare.
Yes.
I've been in horses since I could walk. I could ride a pony when I was about three or four, and I've loved horses, and they've been very good to me over the years. So.
I'm a bit of both. I'm a horse lover that tries to get a commercial result out of it. So Arrowfield is a public company running its business to make profit, but you have to enjoy the horse business to put up with the ups and downs that are involved.
They say you should never get attached to your horses. Do you get attached at times?
Invariably. One shouldn't, but one does. And there's nothing greater than seeing your silks go past the post. The first, it does give you a great thrill, and it's a great draw card for people to come into the industry. So, Simon, do you like this one? This colt?
I think he's got a lot going for him, John. He's one of those old tricks. When he walks out of the box, he grabs you a bit. There's something about him.
He's very
put together.
Yeah. Why don't you give him a bit of a walk and let's have a look at him walk.
Yes, he's got the temperament to be a good racehorse. I think he's calm, but when he stirs up, he does stir up. And he's probably got he keeps that nervous energy ready for a race day, hopefully. They're looking for that tough character. Like the good footballers, they win with injuries and play with injuries, and I think horses are very similar. I think they can go on and go through the pain barrier.
The most important thing, however, is that out of those boxes that you see in front of you, Wayne, hopefully clients will leave satisfied that they've bought something decent and they'll get good results, because at the end of the day, getting winners, not getting high prices, but getting winners gives you enduring success.
I haven't seen the Freedman name on a Magic Millions winner yet.
No, we haven't trained one. We've been second twice, but we've not trained a Magic Millions winner.
I noticed, though, that Flying Spur, which you had to win a Golden Slipper, his first progeny are in this sale.
Yeah, we bought Flying Spur as a yearling, and we trained him to win a Golden Slipper. I bought one of his progeny last night. I bought a little filly out of a mare called Cote Normandy by Flying Spur, and she's for first-time owners, and they're very, very excited about owning her, too.
Right, well, we might see her here next year on the
big
day.
Well, we're hoping. We're all hoping.
Okay. Listen, 1988, the past 12 months, has been an incredible year for Australian racing. On the track, of course, we saw the emergence of a true champion in Martin Power. He became the only horse since Farlap to complete the Caulfield Cup, Melbourne Cup, Cox Plate treble. Off the track, we witnessed the passing of one of the greatest legends in Australian racing ever, TJ Smith. The retirement of race caller Johnny Tapp, and bush poet Murray Harton provides this ode to 1988 and the year of racing.
What a year it's been for racing, the mighty sport of kings. Excitement, raw emotion, 98 at everything.
And Cassidy broke the shackles on Catnip and the Magic Millions favourite blistered clear.
When Pumper nursed home Catnip to deny a flying spend for a Magic Millions win, it somehow set the trend.
She'll break the Magic Millions hoodoo for the Hayes stable, and Catnip won it.
We saw the champion Might and Power truly earn the tag of great. with the Doomben Cup.
Might and Power in front. He's pulling out plenty. He's a champion, all right, Might and Power. He won the cup.
The QE Stakes.
Oh, the champ. Look at him go. And the crowd love him too. Might and Power, the champion racehorse, wins six lengths.
And the WS Cox Plate. The last win proved a miracle. It brought tears from Silent Jack.
This is the one race I'll have water.
And it's long odds that you would have found a dry eye on the track.
He's the best horse I've ever ridden. He'd probably be the best horse I do ever ride, I think.
The Big O went to pasture, never mind the last defeat.
He was still the people's champion.
And when TJ passed away, well, our hearts all skipped a beat. The little general headed skyward, his new assignment's now begun. And with Tullock in his stable, he'll give the Pardon crowd a run.
And they look to be all set and ready, and they're off and running.
Tappy put the peepers down. He called his final race. When you're talking racing legends, he can more than hold his place.
Well, the heart and soul of this business is this magnificent animal called the Thoroughbred.
Then the focus switched to Melbourne. The Poms were jumping up and down.
Racing.
When a cheeky horse from England somehow stole the Caulfield crown. But the sisters who got flattened knew the way to shut them up. The daughters of Zabeel got their own back in the cup.
Jezebel fighting back. Jezebel, Champagne, they hit the line. Jezebel wins the cup from Champagne.
Champagne was pipped by Jezebel, who had Chrissy Munts on board.
I've got some great friends and family in Brisbane who beat the race today. This is for you guys.
For the nice guy of the jockey's room, it was an overdue reward.
One of the great scenes in Australian sport.
There's been drama and elation, tragedy and fame. It's all part of the recipe that makes up the racing game. But if you think things can't get better, let's just say the track is fine. And the form is looking pretty good for 1999.
Looking pretty good indeed, especially with Testarossa winning the Magic Millions. One race to come in our coverage here this afternoon. And don't forget, of course, Big Golf returns to Seven on 4th of Feb with the Greg Norman International. Watch and listen carefully because there could be something in it for you.
Fancy a round with the shark? Seven Sport gives you the chance of a lifetime to play 18 holes with Greg Norman at the Olympic fundraising golf day at the Lakes Golf Club in Sydney on Monday, February 1st. The winner will receive two return flights to Sydney, 1 week's accommodation in Sydney, and two VIP passes to the Greg Norman Holden International, plus two tickets to the opening ceremony of the Sydney 2000 Olympic Games. Phone now, 1902 555 680 for your chance to win.
Yes, your chance to win. Be in it for sure. The Greg Norman International, you could be there. Well, we're here and we're lining up for race 8 on the program, the Queensland Events Handicap. We'll be back to check the field, the starters, the prices, the betting right after this.
Yes, we're set almost for the penultimate event here on the Gold Coast. 3 minutes to race start for race 8, the Queensland Events Handicap over 1,300 metres. Mono Joker has just eased slightly, and Caracas McDittman's mount also has just firmed slightly. Max Presnell.
Mono Joker looks well, looks fit, and showing $5 for the win in Queensland, I thought was perhaps the value in the race. Caracas certainly isn't an imposing type, but is very, very fit. Now, Ice King is the interesting horse because Ice King on the next line is now into $2.70 as we speak. So in Queensland, I think that's very short. Ice King resuming looks reasonable. I don't know, perhaps one more run would just top him off nicely, but the tip is he'll prove too good. I thought, though, at the value, number two, Mono Joker.
So let's have a look at the market movers. And Max, your fancy Ice King early on. Outclassed in the champion stakes at Randwick, over 2,000 metres at its last start. But it's the hot prospect here ahead of Mono Joker and Caracas.
That's about it. They're the three major horses in the market.
So number nine, Ice King, Grant Cooksley, trained by Kevin Connolly at Kalnura. And he is the one they have to beat in this last race. Let's now check betting movements in the ring with Pat Welsh.
Gordon, I know you're close to the club doctor out there. Keep him handy because we may need him for a couple of these bookmakers, Wayne. I've been down there to collect the punters' challenge money from Testarossa, and they are looking a nasty shade, these bookies. They've copped a hiding on the big race.
Oh, that's terrible, isn't it? They have got a heart. They did let us on, and thank God for Testarossa.
Now, looking at this next race, the $2.70 on the tote, or that's our selection for the next one, the favourite. That's a little under the odds. Ice King has been a touch easy in the ring. Some doubts as to whether it's right at its top, but still the feeling is that it'll be too classy for this field.
He looked well. I see him on screen there behind the barrier. He was scratched last week. I hope there was no setback, but they did bring him up here, so they must think he's OK.
Been no major moves on course for anything else in this race. Caracas, I know that's Gary Wilkinson's tip and Richard Friedman's. They like it. It's been solid in the betting. So too has Mono Joker. But I've got a funny feeling the punters may have the money in the pocket and they're quite happy to sit back and relax and enjoy the sights and sounds of Magic Millions Day.
Well, we've got one more to go. We're on Ice King here, so I hope we can get him home.
We might just mention quickly the money from the punters challenge, and it is going to a charity. Perhaps you could tell us a little bit about that right now.
We didn't mention it before because we were a bit frightened of knocking our kitty off, but we can mention it now. The money today that we've put through the Punters Club is going to Leanne Goodwin.
Tragic fall, and obviously a fatal fall at Roma, and just a tragic story to Leanne, and I know we'd love to see you. Love to see the money going their way. So whichever way we finish, we're going to finish up with at least 400 today, and let's hope it's 1,000. And that's where to send your donations if you can, care of Macquarie Film and Television. And there's the number on your screen, 02 9287 2727. And I've just received word that our great friends and they've been supporting us and working with us on this telecast all day. Our friends from Macquarie Film and Television have offered to put in another $500 to add to that. So the family of the late Leanne Goodwin is assured of $900 already, Wayne.
That's lovely, and I hope some people out there are watching this, and hope we've tipped you a winner through the day, and please donate to this worthy cause. It was a tragedy for this family.
Okay, we'll be back in just a moment. We'll go up to you, but let's hope we can turn the $400 remaining into $1,000 for the family of Leanne Goodwin.
Let's hope so. Paddy Welsh, attendance struggling with one or two of the runners behind the 1,300 metre barrier here for the final event in our telecast, the Queensland Events Handicap. And Richard Friedman and myself both think we've got it figured here. Alan Bailey, leading Gold Coast trainer, and Mick Dittman must come up with a winner on the program, and we reckon it's...
They've got to have one today.
Caracas.
It's got to be Caracas.
Has to be Caracas.
He ran second at his last start. It was beaten 5.5 lengths, but that was on a heavy track. I think back on the dry track here today with Mick Dittman in the saddle, barrier 7, and I think Caracas will get the money.
Ice King, the favourite on the tote, and is firmed on the tote, but has been a little easy, as Pat Welsh said, in the ring. Resuming from a spell, it's got to be a question mark over its fitness. It's an interesting race to wind up our telecast here on 1999 Magic Millions Day from the Gold Coast. What a day it has been, the culmination of a sensational week of partying. And as I said, it's not over yet because the sales continue here tonight and for the next couple of days. And we'll be seeing the cream of this crop racing in the Magic Millions next year. Let's go to Wayne Wilson for race 8.
Ready to jump. Caracas Ice King. Sly Dancer stands up well. Lines good. They're racing. Near the inside, Jim Boomberjack hesitated slightly. Operation Payback was fast away. Going quickly, Vane Naribo shortly after the start. Ice King is driving through into a prominent position. He's got him up third on the inside of No Intention. Operation Payback dropping back to fourth on the inside. Mono Joker just niggled along to hold his position. Caracas is trapped wide. He's three deep, heading down the side. Dittman going forward on him. Then our prime mover, Slide Dancer, Jim Boomberjack and Double Duke. They're at the 800-metre point now. No Intention. He's running along out in front. He's letting go. And No Intention slipped around them to go to the lead. Two in front. Into second, Bertha. Vane Naribo. Ice King is a half away third. Caracas is fourth, but he's three deep. He's covering ground. Mono Joker next on the outside of Operation Payback. For the back out, prime mover, Slide Dancer, then Double Duke, and last of all, Jim Boomba Jack, heading for the judge. 400 metres to go. No Intention joined quickly by Ice King. He's cruising up to them on the outside. He's poked his nose in front. 350 metres to go. Ice King just in front of No Intention. Vane Naribo going with Ice King. Ice King King's the first one under pressure now. Vane Naribo hit the lead. Motto Joker coming after them, and Sly Dancer down the outside. Ice King's gone. Vane Naribo in front. Motto Joker, Sly Dancer, our prime mover, charging home late. Here's a bit of a go. They're drawing to the line. Motto Joker's got his nose in front. Photo. Motto Joker or Sly Dancer. Maybe Motto Joker a nose to Sly Dancer, but there's nothing in it. Now prime movers a nose away, third on the outside. Got it in by Vane Naribo. Double Duke next, then Jim Boomba. Jack Operation Payback, no intention. Stopping quickly in the straight was Ice King. By gee, he gave in like a prick balloon. He's finished well back, and Caracas one of the last home. Photo.
The money, although it is a photo. Scott Seamer, top local rider, Gold Coast rider, aboard Mono Joker, was always well fancied, but you've got good odds about it if you fancied it because of the big weight of support for Ice Doctor. And it looks like Mono Joker may have just held on in this photo from Sly Dancer and perhaps our prime mover, finishing powerfully into third place. Photo result, yes, it goes to Mono Joker. Number two is the winner, Mono Joker, Scott Seamer. Second placing, number six, Sly Dancer, and a further photo for third almost certainly will go to our prime mover. Well, that wraps up a great day's coverage here of the Gold Coast Honda Magic Millions for 1999, and what a sensational day it has been. Testarossa winning the big race, General Nadim returning to form in the Amy Cup, which was also fantastic to see, but I think we've got a real horse of the future here with Testarossa.
Testarossa will go on and be one of the best two-year-olds in this country, I've no doubt, so we've seen something very special here today.
Thanks very much to Richard Friedman. Thanks to all of our commentators. A special thanks to our Seven Network technicians and producers here today at the Gold Coast Turf Club and to Macquarie Films and Television. Hope you've enjoyed our coverage. We hope to see you next year for the Magic Millions.